Liver transplantation is usually reserved for patients that have symptoms of end-stage liver disease. This includes problems with what they call hepatic encephalopathy, which is fogginess of the mind that actually can get to the point of actually coma. Problems with fluid retention, usually fluid on the abdomen or swelling in the legs. Problems with bleeding. Basically, patients with liver disease, there's so much scarring in the liver that the blood can't get out of the abdomen through the liver. And at that point, it goes through these small veins around the esophagus. Also, the patients start to lose muscle mass, they become weak, and at the end, they start developing a series of infections since most of the immune system lives inside the liver. The number of people awaiting transplantation is about 15,000 within the United States. Liver donors come from two main sources. The vast majority of the patients, about 5,000 donors a year, are from people that have died in such a situation where their organs are actually functioning well, but their brain has been destroyed and they've been pronounced dead. There's also donors that where the organs are removed from live donors. And this is the case where an adult can give part of their liver to either an infant, which would mean a very small part of the liver, or to an adult where they have to basically give up about half of the liver. That half will grow back in about a month, but it can be a fairly morbid procedure to the donor, usually about a 30% complication rate and probably about a 0.5% mortality rate. So the decision for live donor transplantation is not taken lightly. On the other hand, it can be life-saving in certain situations. Overall, the results of liver transplantation is markedly improved. The average one-year patient survival is 90% and approximately 80% at 3 years. This is improving over the last few years, and we expect it to improve markedly over the next year since we are able to control hepatitis C infections following transplantation. Several of the drug companies have come up with medications that eradicate the virus about 95 to 99%. And with that, the previous significant problem with liver transplantation is that the virus would come back in people with hepatitis C, but now we can get rid of the virus both prior to and following transplantation almost always. And I expect the results to improve over the next few years, probably to around 93 to 95% 1 year patient survival.